example six, we're going to move back to exploring linear inequalities. All the systems of inequalities that we saw so far have an infinite number of solutions. Not this one. This is a system with no solution. So let's take a look. As always, take your inequality and put it in slope-intercept form. So we have x plus y is greater than 3. Subtract x from both sides. We have y is greater than the opposite of x plus 3. Y is greater than negative 1 over 1. X plus 3. Here we have the slope is equal to negative 1 over 1. We have our y-intercept, 0, 3. We draw the y-axis. We start at the point 0, 3. Then from there, go 1 unit down, 1 to the right, 1 unit down, 1 to the right. That's good enough. Let's see what we've got. We have greater than, which means no point on the boundary line satisfies the inequality. So draw a dashed line. And then greater than again suggests upper half plane. So any point that is above this line will satisfy the inequality y is greater than negative x plus 3. You know, if you look carefully at this inequality, you should know right from the start that there is no solution. There's no way that x plus y can be both greater than 3 and less than negative 1. So when you do problems, read the problem carefully. Try to think about what you're doing before you actually start doing the problem. To save a little bit of time, let me just not save time and actually do the second problem here. The second inequality. We have x plus y is less than negative 1. Subtract x from both sides. Y is less than the opposite of x minus 1. Y is less than negative 1 over 1 x minus 1. So, still negative 1 over 1. Just like the last line. Y-intercept, 0, negative 1. I will use a different color. Start by calling the y-intercept, 0, negative 1. From there, go 1 unit down and 1 to the right, that is your slope, and then draw your line. Dash a line once more, because it just says less than. So no point on the boundary line satisfies the inequality and then shade below. What should you notice? You should notice that no point lies above the red line and below the black line. They don't have any points in common, so there is no solution. The two half planes have no points in common. What does that mean? It means the system has no solution. We now move on to example 7. In example 7, we're going to talk about an unbounded solution set. What that means is that we're not going to form a polygon that you are familiar with. Like in the first example we had a triangle. In the second example that we did, we had a graph that was bounded above by a line and below by a parabola. This graph is not going to have boundaries. Let's take a look. X plus y is less than 3. You already graphed this. Subtract x from both sides. y is less than negative 1 over 1x. Plus 3, once more, slope is negative 1 over 1. Y-intercept is the point 0, comma 3. Draw the y-axis, draw the x-axis. Plot the point 0, 3, go 1 down and 1 to the right. Again, less than, so boundary line is dash, no point on it satisfies the inequality, and we want less than 3, so it will shade below. Let's take a look at the second curve. X plus 2y is greater than or equal to 4. The process is exactly the same. Subtract x from both sides. 2y is greater than the opposite of x. Plus 4, divide by 2 on both sides. Y is greater than negative 1 half x. Plus 2, slope of negative 1 half. Y intercept of 0, comma 2. Go. 2 up on the x-axis. I'm sorry, the y-intercept is 0, 2, so go 2 up on the y-axis. And from there, go 1 down and 2 to the right using those two points. Now let's go 1 down and 2 to the right one more time using those three points. Draw a graph to the best of your abilities. For this graph, we would shade above. So greater than suggests the upper half plane. And then what do we notice? We notice that we did not form a triangle, we did not form a rectangle, we did not form any shape whatsoever, but there is only one point of intersection. It looks like that point is the point 2, comma 1. But that's it, one vertex. And then the region is this region in here. Any point in here is a solution to the system of equations. So that's why, because we don't form a polygon, we call this an unbounded solution set.